From the moment he stepped foot in San Antonio, the citizens embraced Archbishop Patrick Flores. More than two decades later, he was still celebrated here. On his 75th birthday, at a time when most would be retiring, he continued his life in the public eye. During his time in the Alamo City, the Archbishop had his share of career highs.
Welcome to Texas, Your Holiness.
He introduced Pope John Paul II to the masses back in 1987 during the Pope's historic pilgrimage to South Texas.
Dice el arzobispo de San Antonio que debo salir.
That experience, a long time in the making, Archbishop Patrick Flores ordained a priest in 1956, serving in Galveston and Houston. He was ordained as auxiliary bishop of San Antonio 14 years later. In 1978, he was appointed Bishop of El Paso. Then, just 1 year later, he became the Archbishop of San Antonio. In June 2000, quite a scare for the Archbishop. An El Salvadoran man, Nelson Escolero, held him hostage for 9 hours. He was released and forgave Escolero.
I'm just hoping and praying that whatever sentence he gets, that somehow that it would be mixed in with medical and psychiatric treatment.
Escolero is serving 65 years in prison. He and the Archbishop would go on to correspond by mail.
Well, what does this mean then?
I don't know. You have to ask him. I didn't write this. Do you understand English? Damn it.
The church sex abuse scandal putting the Archbishop in the hot seat. He would lead the local archdiocese through changes, including background checks on all clergy and employees. And he created an Office of Victim Assistance and Safe Environment, also a recommendation.
This is not a cause for celebration of a job completed. This is only the beginning.
The changes coming as the Archbishop was looking forward to retirement. He spent much of 2004 saying goodbye to friends and parishioners.
I don't have any kind of sadness. In fact, I have joy that I was able to do this ministry all of these years. I've told a lot of people, this is the work of the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit will somehow pull us through, so I'm not going to be afraid as to who's going to take my place. I always say, I think the Holy Spirit will find somebody better, and that the church will go on.